go off tomorrow night. Everybody raise your hands in the air. Introducing to you, make some noise for the legendary Paul Colin. Let me hear you.
Thank you. Hi, and welcome to IntelliJ IDEA Basic.
You may want to also going to make sure that this settings, and I get also content assistance in here. So let's say that for this part, I add it because I it was not the goal here, but you on the Spring Loaded README, you define them as. So it does not fully answer the question because it's in memory, but you basically get the full power of Spring Security. So you can, if you want a database-backed authentication, you can do so through the same mechanism.
Okay, here's another question. Can we configure the web server bundled with Spring Boot with custom configuration?
Project, and basically build a repository of configuration keys. A value to that JSON output. So if I type info, then I can see it's a map. So the first thing which is really annoying about this application is every time it starts, it requires you to look into the logs to find out about the default password. in the weather previously. So the decision that boat is going location and the default user using address. So what we do is we'll change. So I'm going to repository, the speaker repository has been exposed. And I can see that the speakers I have created through that imported SQL file have been processed and can be seen as a RESTful resource. I can also navigate to search methods through that link. And I can see the two search methods that have been exposed, so by Twitter and find my last name. So I can also search by Twitter and search for Trisha and have it here. I told you also about the actuator, and what the actuator provides is certain endpoints like the info endpoints, which give some information about your app, or a Earth endpoint that checks if your app is up and running. I can see that the H2 database is up and some information about disk space. I can look for some metrics, etc., etc. Okay, so that was a Spring Boot app. It took 10 minutes to build it from the ground up, even though I cheated a bit with the templates, but you get the idea. So the first thing which is really annoying about this application is every time it starts, it requires you to look into the logs to find out about the default password. So of course, in a regular app, what you would do is I have to log in again, so it's user change, okay, change me. And you can also see here that the realm says LO3, which is one of the random value between 0 and 5. If I go to the info endpoint, I can see the values that I've set. Okay. And I still have a warning into my configuration file. And this warning, and I could also project structure, facets, and I can also try to, what does it know about all those keys? I'm going to show you. And what IntelliJ as a repository of config you can do, it offers you a way. You may place a file called additional configuration, spring configuration metadata.json. Since the file does not exist for this sample, so string this time. On the top, an annotation variable. It's really something that's local to the project, used by the build process of your project and not exposed as a library that's required to use your app. Okay, so I did create an additional key. And I can see that the file has been generated here. So if I go back and type foo.bar, I can find my additional description here. But, well, you need to manually add those metadata by hand. You may also change your code and the you forget to change the metadata. So it's really a bit painful. So what I want to show you is how you can use that feature and that's change me too. There we go. So these are really a good way for you to, if you have multiple ways of starting a particular Spring Boot application, and if you want to change some settings, you can do so directly here and have multiple run configuration for the same app with slightly different settings. Login again, and that's change me too. And if I go on console, doesn't work. There is no mapping for that. So let's go back to the run configuration here, and let's duplicate this run configuration and call it dev. And then here I can basically say that I want to activate a dev profile. Let's run this up and open a new incognito window. So the your application is not secure anymore, and I can go to the console. And actually look at the window. So the your application is not secure anymore, and I can go to the code. So and actually look at my speaker tenor. If it finds such file, it will basically process it. And to fill it, I'm going to use another feature called Live Template, where you can basically map any shortcut to whatever you want. This is it, I have a DAP. So I'm going to run it. As you can see, as from IntelliJ IDE 14.1, This is it, I have a DAP. So I'm going to run it. As you can see, as from IntelliJ IDE 14.1, the editor has detected that this main class is a Spring Boot application, so it offers a way to start it as a Spring Boot application, as the icon states here. So let's do that. Okay, so I have an application which is starting now. doing some stuff. Okay, so I need to log. console. But I want to activate the dev profile at my screen. Let's run this up and open a new incognito window. So the your application is not secure anymore, and I can go to the
Thank you. Yeah.
guys. We're gonna do something together. I want you to grab your iPhones and put it in flashlight mode. If you got a ladder, put it up in the air. Everybody, put your fucking hands up. Put your hands up. Put your fucking hands up. Put your hands up. Put your fucking hands up. Put your hands up. Put your fucking hands up. Put your hands up. Put your fucking hands up. Let your light shine. Make some noise!
sound.